Welcome to this video playing Mike Poff. Poff. If he plays, I don't know if he's playing. I don't know. Come on. You're still sad about the football match, France-Germany. I'm not quite sure when this video will be released. Probably the World Cup is already over, and we know if Germany managed to win it finally after 24 years. The time of recording, this is not yet clear. Okay, we have the Rui Lopez exchange variation, my specialty with Bishop e7. But he's taking e5. It seems that he actually does know the line. Bishop e6, he can also go g6. It's a funny sideline. Okay. This is a bit uncommon, knight f3. Mostly because I now normally get the queen straighted. Queen f5? I think so. Yeah, and here we have a case where I managed to trade the e-pawns without any particular problem. And I've kept the two bishops here. The only slight issue is that I'm somewhat behind in development and my coordination could be better. How to develop here? Piece coming to e5 is also slightly problematic. And I don't want to give up one of the bishops, of course. This is, let's say, my trump card. Maybe I can go rook e8. That's a bit artificial. Rook e8, knight f6, and then move the bishop. That's very ambitious. I could have played some easy stuff, but let's see. Yeah, still knight f6 simply or not. Oh. I wonder what the idea is. Is there something direct or does he just want to get into this terrible end game? Maybe he wants. Okay. Two bishops against two knights is normally a
Check.
really bad idea. Just rook e8. Yeah, there's no problem with that. My king is slightly deactivated here on e8, but still. I only need to check that he's not able to exchange one of the bishops, which instantly would lead to equality, of course. Yeah, I need to retreat them momentarily and then push the knights back with f5. F5 is clear. It's really questionable. How does he protect the pawn now? G4 was a bad move. He has no way to protect the pawn quite directly. I attack it and he cannot cover it. Okay, just b6. It's really not a big threat, knight c5. But why not b6? Asking black what the knight is exactly doing on a3, on a4. Yeah, I'll take this next move. And the bishops and the pawn, that's a bit much. So how to continue? I can, of course, use my pawns. Okay, can he go king e5? This would be a bit of an annoyance. Should I play bishop d6 to make sure this is not happening? Maybe it's not nice to give up the pawn, the bishop, but okay. It's still excellent for black. G5.
Mm-hmm. Check.
Go d5. Mm-hmm. Yeah, why not? Knight f6. King is a. This is a journey with no return ticket.
Check.
Yeah, no, this is going to. Oh, I can go to h5. Okay, that's true. How to do it now? Maybe just grab more space. King over, I guess. King to e5. Yeah, this is one way to do it. Going to d1 at the end. Take here.
Check.
And then bishop d1. Nice, pawns are on light squares.
Check.
Go here, f6 to e8. That's probably the easiest. Knight
Check.
f6, king e6. Knight e8, so then he can pick up a6, but I can grab the whole queen side.
Check.
Now knight b8, king c7. It's really
White
trapped.
Resigns.
Yeah, this is a very typical case where. A wrong continuation early led to a very prospectless game. Here white absolutely must play d3 to fight for an advantage. The idea is that after knight f6 you go knight f3 and
Check.
This here is the way it is continued. Here white can try to play on for something. It's pretty okay for black, but it's nothing special. Yeah, here I get the pawn back, and yeah, I can take c2, but I wasn't interested in that. I was just thinking, okay, get the queens off. And here black is very comfortable. It's just a matter how to play it precisely. Rook e8 is an ambitious move. It wants to play knight f6, so that rook e7 is not possible. So it's a preparation move, and I'm not sure about this move, bishop g5. You never want to take on f6, really, and he did that. He took here, which is quite remarkable, just giving me the total bishop pair. And here, yeah, the easiest is to just trade off rooks, which I
Check.
Did. And here, of course, black is just much more comfortable. This is not helping him much, but the real problem was g4. After that, he's losing. I mean, if you play decently from here, you have chances to set up a fortress, yeah, or something like that. It's pure passive defense, but still possible. Maybe f4, a move like that. After g4, f5, he's just giving up a pawn, and is losing basically. Okay, thanks for watching.